Students of SD College Academy, I wish you a warm welcome to all our SD College and we'll start the lesson.
All right. Good morning, everybody. Asking we are waiting for our very second mega presentation. Today, we are blessed to have Professor B. Hanumaiya, former VC, Baba Saheb Bhimrao Ambedkar University, Professor D.K. Maheshwari, Professor and Head, Department of Botany and Microbiology, Dr. Hemant Group, Secretary, and former Principal, ADSBG, College of Arts and Science and Commerce. I extend a warm welcome to all of you to this principal's presentation. We hope we are going to learn much more in this particular course of visit, and we wish you for to hear from you to go ahead for long. Thank you all. Anyway, Dr. Nadalaya, Principal to Assembly.
Management, staff and students, welcome to the dear team members, Professor B. Hanumaiya, Professor D.K. Maheshwari, Dr. M. R. Guru.
No, you put out that.
Nalanda Dharma College, a brief profile and the post re-accreditation initiatives by IQAC and next year income. Bowing our heads before the fond memories of our founders, for the opportunity they have created for our journey till now, Swathasthi Iyengar and Sundar Rajan Naidu. About us, Alappuzha, known as the Venice of the East, rural and semi-urban areas. And this is one of the oldest and largest aided colleges in Kerala, established on 20th June 1946. 70 years of glorious experience, existence is over. We are entering into 71st year. Extension from Sanatana Dharma Vidyasala, SDV, trust in 1905, under the inspirational leadership of Madam Annie Besant, Theosophical Society. SDV Trust is a non-profit making organization that has made substantial contribution to the social, educational and cultural milieu of the otherwise backward district of Kerala. Grand in aid, multi-faculty, co-educational institution recognized under 2 subsection F and 12B. Cross-section of Alappuzha. The majority of the persons belonging to agricultural workers, including paddy cultivators, fire workers, fishermen, and small-scale traders of many kinds. SD College was shifted to the current location in 1950. College was constructed by collecting money from public as donations and contributions from people across the country. Started with a national diploma in commerce in 1946 with 125 students. Became a full-fledged major A-grade college at present with 13 UG programs, 9 PG programs and PhD programs in 6 subjects. We do have research centers in botany, zoology, commerce, chemistry, economics and mathematics. Total number of students at present, 2,337. Teaching strength, 110. Number of administrative supporting staff, 43. Total area of our college, 46 acres. Total built-up area, 15,195 square meters. The original building was built in the shape of alphabet E. Resembles equity, efficiency, and excellence. Even at the time of cross-commercialization of education, we hold on to our value, core values of equity and excellence, quality education to the needy public of Alappi and outside. 80% of the seats under merit come reservation, that is the admission policy of our college, 20% management seats, and upholding the value of quality and merit, management fixes minimum cutoff in allocated seat even under management quota. Admission in management quota without caste religious considerations. Socioeconomic profile. Compared to other colleges in Alappuzha, more than 80% of the students come from very ordinary families with a low income and parental education levels. Many are first generation leaders from rural areas. Nearly 70% of the students are girls. We always take the challenge of bringing out the best in them. Regarding the assessment and accreditation, college volunteered for the assessment and accreditation process during 2008 itself and was the second college in Kerala to do so. Accredited with a 4-star in 2000 and re-accredited in 2011 with the A grade by NAC. We now turn to the post-accreditation initiatives undertaken by the college. And there were some observations in the last NAC team visit. On the basis of the observation, we have done the following elements. Number one, establish more collaborative linkage with the other institutions for teaching and learning. The actions taken by us, number one, tie up with Amrita University using virtual lab facility, MOU with the Phoenix Institute of Financial Training Private Limited, MOU with the Center for Continuing Education, Government of Kerala, MOU between Department of Chemistry, SD College and Department of Chemistry, St. Michael's College, Sarkana, collaboration with the Teaching Learning Center, IIT, Madras, MOU with the Surindra Oriental Research Institute for Research Collaboration. Besides these, individual details have made their own association with many institutions like IISER, IUCCAA, NIST, Indian Institute of Science, Inter University Center, Indian Institute of Advanced Studies. Then the second observation was that regarding enhanced entrepreneurship skill and development programs. We have done. ED Club Initiatives identifies the initiatives having entrepreneurial capabilities and provide a platform to display the skills. We already constituted an entrepreneurship development club. As for the recommendation made by the peer team, the college introduced an additional skill acquisition program, ASAC, from the year 2012 through MOU with the Government of Kerala. Regular skill development classes, training sessions, and career counseling to empower the students to excel in the highly competitive job market. A special 21-day residential program for final-year degree students were carried out successfully from the last 5 years since 2012. The college has converted ASAP into a comprehensive skill enhancement and career guidance program under the aegis of the Career Guidance and Placement Cell. Career Guidance and Placement Cell regularly organizes mock interviews, writing workshops, training on computer applications, etc. College has introduced Walk with a Scholar WWS program for bright students and Scholar Support Program SSP for weak students, in which they are giving external mentoring to enhance their skills through expert lectures and visit to other institutions and industries. Observation 3. Library and finance section may be fully computerized. All office staff were provided with computers and net facility. All files including provident fund, fees, scholarship and salary bills are prepared through computer softwares. The library is now fully automated with the Koha software. Koha is a web-based software having modules that support all library operations. We now use in-house barcoding system for documents and also member profiles. The software is capable of having Z39-point facility for interoperability with the international catalog and cataloging facilities. Our library is using Library of Congress and the catalog of the Singapore National University as the benchmark for rendering. understand it. Observation 4 regarding teaching learning process. Establish more collaborative linkage with other institutes for teaching and research. Innovations in teaching process with more ICT aids. Science students use the virtual laboratory experiment. Process with more ICT aids. Action second. Science students use virtual laboratory experiments. NIST program of InfliptNet provides online access to information sources, books, national and international journals. 171 computers linked with the local area network located in 12 departments. And computer center provides basic ICT support for teaching, learning, and evaluation. 10 rooms have been developed as smart classrooms with the support of LCD projectors. Interactive boards are provided to 5 departments. A central computer room with a capacity of accommodating 60 computers has been built up. 35 computers have been installed and the rest will be installed in the month of July with the support of MLA fund. Language lab with the modern software provides ICT enabled support for imparting language skills. In the new northern block, separate room is envisioned to it. Audiovisual lab used by language departments. Moodle, modular object-oriented dynamic learning environment, course management software. Information related to academics will be provided to 24/7 as part of our commitment to quality enhancement. Feedback on teachers is now being selectively undertaken electronically through Moodle software. Our faculty and research scholars have access to electronic thesis and dissertations through Shodh Ganga, a project of UGC. In all PG departments, there is at least one projector. Enabled classroom, students conduct seminar and project presentation using LCD projectors. Mathematical softwares have been purchased for the use of students, teachers and research scholars. Language departments use IT facilities to present visual aids, movies, videos, etc. of study resources. An interdisciplinary common instrumentation center with the ICT facilities has been built up for interdisciplinary research in science. Then observation 5, enhancement of staff, teacher and student welfare programs. Actions taken by us. The ST Goda Employees Cooperative Society provides loans up to 8 lakhs with a minimum procedural delay. A special scheme of emergency loan with a very minimal interest rate has been introduced by ST Goda Cooperative Society as per the request made by the IQC. Group efforts involving staff, students and alumni have been initiated to provide much needed relief when medical aid is needed. Staff alone have collected Rs 24 lakhs for such purpose in the recent years. Informal financial assistance for contingency given to students through the respective department. The ST Goda Employees Cooperative Society provides loan up to 8 lakhs with minimum procedure delay. Observation 6, job-oriented programs. The action taken by us, the Sub-Centre for Continuing Education Kerala offered advanced diploma in logistics and retail management, professional diploma in hardware and networking, IT related certificate courses in computer networking and software development. Coaching for ICWA was offered by in association with the ICWA chapter. Intensive bank examination coaching is given to students under the auspices of Department of Commerce. Intensive coaching is given to shortlisted candidates for appearing for the campus placement drive of commercial banks. mock interviews, group discussions and soft skill development program are conducted by Career Guidance and Placement Cell for passing out batches. Orientation for civil service examination has been organized. Physics Gurukulam gives training to students to appear for competitive examination and enhance employability of students. Then observation 7, skill-oriented training programs are to be organized for non-teaching staff. The action taken by us, orientation classes were arranged on SPAR, managing salary bill and MSOP. Non-teaching staff were sent to attend informal training sessions arranged by authorities like Director of College Education and Deputy Director of College Education. Orientation classes were arranged on SPAR and MSOP. Non-teaching staff were sent to attend informal training sessions. Hostel facilities we created for male students, that was another observation. There is not much demand from the male students of the college for residence facility. If requested by the male student, the college can make residential arrangements outside with some agency. The students belonging to places outside Alberta are mainly girls. Then central instrumentation center may be established. The action taken by us, college has built an interdisciplinary instrumentation center under FIST project. To keep the equipment under this project, management has constructed a separate building as a research block, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam Research Center. IQC is planning further to expand this center as a research hub, including social science research. A central computer center is also established, which can accommodate 60 computers at a time. For nanoscience research, a material research center is created under SART project. Observation 10. Being semi-urban area, the college facilities may be utilized for teaching spoken English to local population. The action taken by us, although efforts have been initiated in this dimension, there was no positive response from the local population. Though we communicated this to different sections including the local population associated with the tourism sector, it could not be materialized. The fact is that over the past years, there are many local centers giving spoken English classes at their convenience.